I subscribe to my channel. Hit like, comment, and notification button. Don't forget to share.
Good morning, YouTube. How y'all doing? Well, today is Friday. It's Friday, you guys. How is it going out there?
How is it going?
Okay, YouTube. I am about to get myself together this morning, so come and join me. You know you have to wash this face. Don't y'all just pop up and go play no PlayStation and Xboxes, you know, and go and have breakfast. But anyway, this is what I'm using. This for my face. You know I don't take a bath in it, but I do get my face and my neck because my head is connected to my neck, so I want it all to be combined together. The bursts is in it. They got those little beads in it. Make sure I don't get this stuff in my eyes, you guys. I'm gonna have a towel. Okay, I guess I have to wash cup. I don't use all my towels due to this corona stuff. I'm starting to use more towels than anything. Okay. Got that out of the way. Now my next step is to brush this tongue. You think your breath stink due to your tongue, your teeth? Heck no. Your breath stink due to that old nasty weapon in your mouth. It's your tongue. Because all the food that you don't eat sits on that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Turn this water on before we have a highest water bill. Can't leave out this. Can't leave that out. Take my flossing gear and I floss. Oh. Oh. was like the keeper. The small towel. I gotta see someone. A small towel because I like them dry. And my lips are still chapped. And I use this. I tell you what, I don't have to do all that. I use this. I could just darken this up on my phone. Instead of doing all that and this, I don't have time for that. And I just take a little finger. You come on, something smells good. Do I do this every morning? On my days off, I do. And at night, if I don't do it at night, I try to do it in the morning. I give my face a good massage. Your face will really appreciate this massage. It really, really will, trust me. Now what I'm about to do, trying to think, am I gonna put a unit on today? Let me find a unit. And what I mean unit, you ladies know what I mean, a wig. Okay guys, I just licked my edges down. I'm out. I need to go and grab some more. And I put this on. I just want my edges to be laid down. I'm not worried about this part. I want more of that part. And I have my little stocking cap. This is a stocking I bought and I messed it up. I ruined it. So I just cut it. And kept, you know, don't throw your stock away, lady. Use it as this. Instead of going to the hair store buying it for a dollar, you already bought it. See, even though it have a hole in it, it's still gonna do what I need it to do. And I'm going to wrap this back up. This is like a silk one. And let this sit and I decide whether I'm gonna put on a wig or not. Okay, got that out of the way and let me put my stuff away. Clean my bathroom back up. I'll be back. If I can find the pause button on here, because I have it so bright. And I think I'm about to fuck it up. So, I don't know where my pause button. Here it goes. I'll be back. Okay, you two. I am back. So, I just went and add a little eyelashes. I mean, not eyelash. Eyeshadow. And some little lip gloss and now what I want to do is this is it for now, for today, not for now, for today, because I'm not going to add all that foundation and all the other stuff what the other ladies do. It's just too hot for that at this moment. I can, my face cannot tolerate all that makeup. So, this is it. I went with green. I went with green today. So I do have some things that I need to tidy up real quick before 12 o'clock. And I will be back. I will be back. You guys, come back. Don't leave. Don't leave. Just go subscribe to my channel. Hit like, comment, and notification button. Don't forget to do the next thing after that one. It's to share. Sharing is caring. Corona! Coronavirus! How did y'all like my little short video? Go check it out if you did. It's called A Bee in the Bag, and I did it off of TikTok. Oh, yeah. Go to my TikTok also. You'll see the little symbol on the side with my name on it. Go to my TikTok. TikTok. I'm doing TikTok. So I'll be back shortly. Be back.
Okay, you guys, I am back. Yes, I am. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. I paused my video for about an hour. It's good that you can always go back and finish. You can start where you stopped at. And I had to go and, I didn't have to, but I went and did a couple videos on my TikTok. So go over and check out my TikTok. And I'll tell you what it is later on when I get up and go grab my phone. But I had a banana for breakfast, and that was not enough. So what I did, I'm gonna tell you something about this bowl. Go to Family Dollar. They only a dollar. Go to Family Dollar, buy, ask them where are they bowls with this seal on top. They are a dollar. I would say it again, only a dollar. Go and grab some for yourself, your husband, your children. And I know now we make these instant grits. A lot of us don't do grits like our grandparents did. But I still do. Either or, the grits are good. But I used to do my box grits, but I'm not going to do it anymore. When I say box, I mean the quick fix. I'm going back to doing them my regular way, like my grandmother did. And my mommy. So now it's quicker. You go and buy a bowl with the seal on top at Family Dollar for a dollar. Put you about 3 or 4 teaspoons in this bad boy. Add a lot of water to it and put it in the microwave for like 5, but leave the vent open so the steam can come out. Don't close the vent, because if you close the vent, it's going to pop and explode everywhere. Okay? Even oatmeal, you know, add your milk, you know, water don't do it. Water don't set well with oatmeal. I'm sorry. And, do your grits. And while you're doing your grits, you know, for your kids or for yourself, you know, have your toast going. Let your egg be the last thing you do. Your egg and your meat. But your meat can be cooking while your grits cooking. And once the grits get done, once your grits are finished, you just close the seal and keep the heat inside so your grits won't get cold. Go and give it a try. Because these grits is hot. I'm sitting here just chewing and chewing and chewing. But anyway, okay, I had to, I'm going to add some cheese. I went to add cheese to my grits. That give it a kick, boy. And I'm going to have in apple juice. Like I said, I can't do the hand thing. All this here, all that ain't necessary for me. I just take my foam and make it a little darker. But anyway, and brighten it back up. You guys, I'm coming on here talk about Beam Squad. The Beam Squad crew. I'm moving my mic around. And I know it's making some noise. Okay, like I was saying, the Beam Squad. I went and looked at it, and I was going to make a video soon as I seen it, but I couldn't because it made me sad. I got sad. And it really touched me. It really, really touched my heart. And I know it bothered you guys if you have a heart. We all have a heart. But when I say if you have a heart, meaning you have sympathy for people. And don't judge them. My grit's getting cold. And you have a heart, you have sympathy for people. And you can respect what they had to do to take care of themselves and their family. And I do. What they did was wrong. Of course, they knew. They knew what they did was wrong. They know what they did was wrong. And, you know, they have to pay for what they did. But judge not, want not. You're not God, and you cannot. You can if you can. We can judge, but it doesn't matter whether we judge them or not, for the good or the bad. But they have to stand in front of God and be judged. But as long as they go and ask for forgiveness, what they did, and then again, it's in the Bible saying that if you steal food, and I'm not saying go and steal food. But if you steal food, it's not a sin because you're hungry. But if you're stealing food and you know you're not hungry, then that's a sin. It's in the Bible. I kid you not. It's in the Bible. So what they did, and confess, you know what they did. On YouTube in front of all their subscribers. And we have to give them props for that. Not props for what they did, but props for telling us their business. Because they didn't have to tell us. It was their business. They didn't have to come on YouTube and tell us nothing was going on behind their closed doors. But they did. So by them doing that, don't judge them. Don't go posting stuff on their comments. Negative stuff. You get what I'm saying? Because think about it, if that was your mother, if you love your mother and your grandmother with all your heart, mind, and soul, and if that was your grandmother, your mother, and you know how we get about our parents, we act a fool. So don't judge them. You don't want nobody messing with your sister and your brothers. You know this. You'll go to hell and high water for your family. This is somebody's family. Remember that. And they'll go to hell and high water too. So let's support them, okay? I don't have a lot of subscribers like you guys do. But one thing I do have that you guys have, that'll be a heart. I have a heart. And I have love for people. And if you have love for people and you have a heart, and you feel, you know, you're going to uplift people, then I have something where you have. I might not have all these subscribers, but I do have that much. I have my pride and my dignity, you know, and my respect for myself and others. Because if my kids had to do what they did, If I had to do it, then I had to do it. And there's some things that I'm going to say it. I'm not going to get into detail about my business because that's my business. That ain't y'all for the business. But I did some things when I was in my, not 20s. When I was in my, it was in my 20s. Between my 20s and my 30s. And then, you know, nothing about selling my body and stuff like that. Stripping, which there's nothing with stripping and all that good stuff. It's tax-free, baby. Get y'all money. But, and it don't have anything to do with, for, you know, money, forging money or whatever. It's all about me making money. I made money. But I'm, you figure it out. Shit, you ain't dumb. You is not dumb. But I did. And I did it. And I was working on top of it. I didn't have a car. I had 5 children. I didn't have a car. But what I did for my children. Like I said, I didn't have a car. I had to catch the taxi to work. Sometimes I used to walk to work and it'd be dark outside. It was dark. And I never did hard drugs. I smoked weed. Hell yeah, I smoked weed. I was high as a kite. I was high as a kite, but never did drugs. Get what I'm saying? But I walked to work, called a cab sometime. Back then, it wasn't no Uber. It was the cab. Yellow top. And I did my thing on the side or whatever. And I made enough money, and I bought me a car. Nice car. It was a Buick, 4-door, white, green interior inside. Every buttons, not the roll-up, but the button. The inside was the bomb. I paid $900 for it. This white man sold it to my old white man for $900. It was nice. That thing was right good. Me and my children, we had a car. We was good, you know. I was living with a friend. And I end up getting me. I didn't buy it, but I was renting this trailer. You know, and then I end up on Section A. Section A came through. I got on Section A. I went June and was on it. They approved me in August. I was getting my own place. So ever since then, I had my own place. Me and my kids were living good, comfortable. And then I stopped doing that little side hustle thing. And, I had a job. I had quit that job and started working with the Board of Education, you know. So now I'm doing well. And I bought a car, paid it off, bought a van because I had 5 children. No, I bought my van first. I had a van because I had my 5 children. Then I had a car. So for me, when I'm not driving, you know, taking my kids and their friend places. I was the van mom, soccer mom. I took them everywhere they wanted to go. Even when my kids went swimming, I would go home and make sandwiches for all the kids in the swimming pool. Baby, it could have been my 40, 50 damn children in that pool, but I made sandwiches and chips and juice. And I pretty much fed all the kids that was at the swimming pool. I surely did that. And after that, once I got a van, got a car, you guys, I was good. I was good. And ever since then, I've been doing well. Don't have anything to complain about. So that's why I said, let's not judge them. Let's respect them and lift them up. And she's pregnant and she don't need to be stressing out about this stuff. And for the neighbors to go and want them to be removed out their home with their children, you guys are not neighbors. You are demons and you are evil. How could you ask a couple to move out with two babies and one on the way? Why? Why? I don't get it, you guys, but I'm pretty sure you guys already looked at the video as well as I did, and I just want to point out some things, you know, about them. And she's very emotional, and when you're pregnant, you're going to be very emotional. You guys know this. So let's keep them uplifted. Let's pray for them. Send out hearts on their comments. Love, 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 love. Laugh, laugh, laugh. You know, and it's going to get better. You know, what you do in the dark going to come to the light eventually. So don't do anything for it to come to the light and bite you in the ass. You know, but if you got to do what you got to do, then that's just the ball game. That's just the way the cookie crumbles. So I'm sitting here watching them and I have it on low. So you can pretty much hear a little bit what they're saying. Listen.
Do better, Mrs. Like, you wanted to change. Wanted to do better. You know, I quit doing that stuff. I had got a job. I had got a security job. I started doing Uber while I was doing security at night. I did Uber during the day.
We went broke a couple times.
We went broke a couple times.
Because we was dumb, not saving money, just was not spending.
Doing dumb stuff, you know?
Yep.
And Eva
was, I was baking.
She was baking, trying to make her little side money.
Mm-hmm.
I was doing,
like you said, Uber.
Uber and the security job. And then she was begging me to do YouTube, begging me to do YouTube. And I was like,
nah. Thought she was like, I don't know what
I was like, I was not in the mindset to do it. Like, I was not, because my living situation wasn't all that good. And I was like, I didn't want to put myself on camera at the time. I didn't want to do none of that stuff. So, you know, it came to a time where, you know, I gave in and she kept telling, we can do this. And I had already had, you know, editing skills already.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, you know what, let me just put the editing skills to use and then,
like, just created 360.
And we just started doing YouTube, and, you know, things started changing for us around that time. But, you know.
And the reason in the last video, I kept saying this was 5 years ago,
Yeah.
Is because, like, I want to make it clear that we weren't scamming.
While doing YouTube.
While you doing YouTube and trying to act like we live a whole nother life, like living a double life. And we was not smart enough. We was not
smart
enough to save our money long enough to be able to afford.
You see, stuff happen. You know, stuff happen, you guys. But anyway, I'm in the middle of my video at 3.5, and I want to say go and subscribe to my channel, hit like, comment, and notification button, and don't forget to share, you guys. Sharing is very important. So go and subscribe to my channel. Get me up to 500. If I'm on your channel, support me as well as I'm supporting you. You know, take a little time out. You know, a lot of you YouTubers not going places. And a lot of you probably not working. But anyway, if you are doing all that, just go subscribe to my channel. I only have 23, 24, but I have a lot of views. I'm getting a lot of views, you know. But I need you guys to don't pay that no attention, man. Because this is my, like, background. That's my background, you guys. I'm taking that down. I'm going to go to Walmart and measure how much I want for my background. And I'm just going to go with something fancy. Yeah, I'm going to Walmart. Probably go tomorrow in the morning. Because actually, it's 12 o'clock and I don't want to be out there. I was out there yesterday and without my mask and I wasn't worried. I'm not scared of C-19. I'm not afraid. I just be careful and be cautious. But me being afraid of that infection or whatever, nah. It's nothing to be afraid of. I'm not going to isolate myself from the world. You know, my immune system is good. I have a good immune system because I eat healthy and I take care of myself. You know, I'm dropping off the subway, of course. That's what I do. I don't stay on task. But my immune system is awesome. Thank God.
because I pray over this piece of body and I sage myself. You know what I'm saying? A lot. I do it a lot. So, and I anoint my own self. I have my own oil and I prayed on my own oil. And I anoint my house and myself, these rooms and stuff like that. So I'm good. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid of Corona 19. Just like Ebola and all that good stuff. That too shall pass. And I always say, let that cup pass me. But anyway, yeah, you guys go subscribe to my channel, please. I really, really appreciate it. I need 500. And the crazy thing, you guys, the crazy, crazy thing, I started my YouTube channel in 2010 and I stopped. Now imagine if I would have continued on with it way before a lot of these people have, you know. But I stopped. I didn't think it was going to be this big. So now I'm at the bottom. Now I'm here. But anyway, let's go and finish this video of this, the Beam Squad, and see what they got going on. Guys, let's finish. Wrong one.
This life, and that's why they didn't seize our house, they didn't seize any of our cars,
they didn't seize anything because everything was legit.
Everything's legit.
They couldn't take those from us because everything was legit.
We worked for that,
you know. So,
but anyway, so we did a 360, we changed our life. So, in 2019 came, long story short. I was pregnant. I don't know where. We didn't know we was being investigated.
Yeah, we didn't know anything.
For the past 3 years, I mean 4 years, I don't know. We just didn't know.
We were just living our life, and then
that life just yes. So far. It was like a bleep in time. It was like
yes.
Oh, it was just like not us anymore.
Yeah, it just felt so good to, you know, do
everything right.
Everything right, like
that's right.
It just felt so good, you know. When people used to ask me, like, what do you do for a living? I would be so happy to say I'm a content creator. I do videos on YouTube.
Mm-hmm,
before,
mm-hmm.
I couldn't say that. Like, I was always in the shadows, trying to hide, doing this.
Paranoia.
You know, paranoia. It comes with a lot. And I didn't want to live that type of lifestyle anymore. So, you know, having a kid and...
Yeah, having ourselves.
Now, that's just like people selling drugs. You always have to be up. Out through the night, watching your back, making sure nobody trying to get you, making sure the Fed not after you, making sure the police is not watching you, the detectives and stuff, somebody, you know, telling or snitching on you. You know, snitches. You know what happened to snitches? You know, snitches get stitches, baby. Trust and believe me on that one. But anyway, and you constantly up. You up out through the night. You constantly watching your back. You scared. You taking a chance. You don't know who you dealing with out there. I'm telling you for self-experience. Now you know what I used to do. I'm telling you for self-experience. You got to go and make sure that your stuff is put away. You know, it's a lot. So it's best to do right and live right. But like I said, you have to do what you got to do at that time to survive. And now we are back in poverty and things are different. So you don't have to do that. There's other options out there, you know. Besides robbing, stealing, and killing. Let's not go there. Let's not do that. Nah, that's not worth it. Not taking somebody's life. Cause everybody trying to live and everybody trying to survive. Out here in this mean, evil, nasty world. And God did not create this world to be like that. But humans have done it. We have just destroyed the earth. Sending stuff up in space and all that crazy stuff. We don't do that. Our hands are washed off on that one. I'm sorry. Yeah. No, we don't send stuff up in space. Then again, it could be a good thing. It could be a bad thing. I don't know. I don't know scientists. So, anyway, let's finish the Beam Squad.
Having Messiah basically changed our whole mindset.
That's
a
great thing. Good.
We started on the up grind.
Yeah, we just started to change our life, you know?
I know we struggled too, because I know you guys saw, like, when we was on YouTube, some of you guys saw our couch. We used to rank our couch all the time, mm-hmm. and talk bad about how ugly it was and why we don't just buy a new one.
because we didn't have money around that time.
Things were bad for us. We moved into Billy's mom. And we still kept grinding. We never stopped grinding. We tried hard. And we was able to move into this house here. And that's when really things started really getting good for us.
Mm-hmm.
We
Amen.
Started fulfilling ourselves more.
Yeah.
And anyway, so February 2019, we got invited. Eventually, we decided to take a plea. And now, Monday, 2 days ago.
Yeah, we got sentenced.
No.
So basically, I got 2 years. And Yvonne got 1 year.
I got a year and a day.
She has a year and a day.
It's crazy. I'm thankful because, guys.
That's right.
We were facing 7 to 8 years.
Yeah, we was facing 7 to 8. No, I'm just thankful for the outcome. It's either way is good at the end of it, the way I see it.
Because we did bad. And when you do negative things, you can't expect not to get a negative outcome. We knew this was going to happen.
Yeah.
We knew it was going to get time.
Because we put negative energy into the world, you know, and eventually that energy is going to come back some way or another.
I'm thankful for our lawyers. Like, the whole team that's still behind us, our manager, without him, we wouldn't be prepared for anything. Like,
for
everything. And it's like, just so you guys know, our sentence is staggered. So that basically means Billy's gonna go through his time first.
Yeah, I'm gonna do my time first, and then when I get out,
and you're done with
when
your
I'm
sentence,
done with everything,
I go in for the
like
year.
30 days
after
I come home,
and
she does her year or however long, 10 months or whatever it may be. She does her whole full year, and then she'll be done, and then
it's up from there.
Yeah.
So there's so much more to this story, and we did document everything that we were going through, the ups and the downs. And
yeah, we did.
Like,
so that video is going to end. I mean, not video, but the YouTube is going to end. I'm going
right
so
now,
over my time, but right now, I don't care. Billy have to go to jail for 2 years, and then his girl wife have to go for a year, a couple months. Dang, I'm hoping that they'll be able to still continue. I'm hoping she can continue on to hold down the YouTube thing. That she can hold down the YouTube blog while he's locked up. And once he get out, because that'll give her a chance to raise the kids. It's going to be hard to raise them without him. But that'll give her, you know, she can still raise the kids. And then when he get out, he can raise the kids and continue on the video. So, gee whiz, my word. I'm hoping he can get out on good behavior. He may not have to do the whole year unless it's fed time, I'm assuming. But, my, oh, my, oh, my. This is why I didn't want to do a blog. Pick a time, reset tonight. Reset tonight. Yeah, so she's crying, you guys. She is crying. I'm going to turn it back this way before I start crying.
Talking to each other.
It's sad.
It is sad, but you know,
I'm not worried about Sire anymore because what I expected from him, he's been proving me different. Like every day, like he's just realizing how strong he is, and like the way we fought, he sure was totally different. Stronger than me. It's because he's a kid. But anyways, you guys, I want to thank you guys too because we have so much support and so much to show the judge because of you guys. Like, so much
positive words from you guys.
The fact that he allowed us to be able to, one of us to be home with the kids at a time.
That's good. That's good. Yeah.
I gotta thank God, because if it didn't come into our hearts to change and to become better people, we would have been gone
through. We wouldn't be here right now.
And most importantly, even though we feel like they came 5 years after, I'm so grateful for that. I like them. Like, I find peace and I've never been to stop. And Sia loves doing YouTube, and he calls us lazy when he doesn't know, like.
Okay, you guys. I'm lost. I kind of got stuck just then. I rebuke this in the name of Jesus. Father God, that you reverse their situation, Jesus. I pray, Lord, that they have faith in the mustard seed. That you laid on this judge heart, Father God, to call them and have let him allow the judge to have a change of mind, change of heart, Father God, that they don't get sentenced, that they can be there to raise their children. I'm not asking anything about the YouTube channel, Father God. I'm just asking in your name, Jesus, that you reverse this, Father God. Lay it on the judge heart, Jesus, because the judge is your child as well as they are, Father God. That you uplift this jail time on them, Father God. I ask in your name, Jesus. I rebuke it, Father God. I speak on it, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Amen. You guys, they're not going to jail. If they go to jail, I just pray that the way they went in, with an open heart and trust and believe and have faith in our God, that they come out doing the same thing. But Jesus, I just pray that they don't have to go. I don't want their music on my YouTube channel. But I just want to come on here and say that that's all. I was going to do it last night, but I was too dang old blessed and tired. I was too tired. Couldn't install. We try shortly at 11:40. Okay, cool. My computer trying to do something. This computer I have, you guys, is an all-in-one. It don't have that tower, the big, huge tower sit on the side. I don't have that. I don't have that. I have an all-in-one computer. And it hooks up to the Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi. This is when they first started.
A few months ahead of us, going to Tampa tomorrow.
Miami. Oh, I'm at 254.
Georgia in July. A big week coming. But the tip of the day, guys, is stay motivated.
That is pretty.
Stay active. Stay consistent, you know. If you feel it, like if you're doing something, while you're doing
Oh, she is so skinny.
The outcome being what you want.
And the quality of their video is poor. So you know when you begin your YouTube. I am not trying to hit nobody. Who is this? Oh, it's Marilyn. I'm hoping when people do blogs about them that is no clap back and coming at them in a negative way. Let it be positive. You two couple who scam and stole millions from people and fake tax return, the Beam Squad. Really? Y'all niggas is some serious. Game Master took the villain. Y'all niggas some serious. I just can't. Okay. I don't went over the 31. I'm going to do 35. I'm going to do 35 and be done. This is how my video used to be. The little square. 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 I remember doing my videos like that till I went to download this app on this phone because I wasn't going to buy no damn camera. You get what I'm saying? Buy a camera. I don't have to buy a camera because I have this phone, which I did buy a camera. I was going to go buy another one, but it wasn't no use in me buying another camera when I could have downloaded this app. So I have three phones. I have the app on each one of my phones, and I have my little own little speaker right there, which I am going to get a better speaker. I'll probably go Best Buy tomorrow and buy me a better speaker for my phone. But this worked just fine for now. So anyway. But anyway, you guys, I'm about to get ready to get out of here. And don't forget to go and subscribe to my channel. You know. And I'm just gonna see and look at a couple of videos of the Bean Squad when they first started out. I love looking at people videos when they first started out to where they are now. So I can learn. I can teach myself because I'm willing to learn. I have some chapstick, you guys. Excuse me. Okay. I want to hear what Melinda, what she's talking about.
All right, now this leads to that. How is it that, I don't even know if people saying we wrong or not. I just don't understand if somebody do say we wrong, if somebody keep talking, you're going to have to defend yourself, especially last night. Excuse me, I'm selfish. I don't let Messiah, I don't do something to Jimmy. Jimmy is a good person. He treats Messiah right. He's just irresponsible when it comes to him being around Amanda whenever they argue. I don't know if they changed, if their relationship got better and they act different, but I will never forget about the time when Messiah almost drowned while he was with y'all. So, of course, I'm not going to let Messiah go around y'all any type of day, whenever you want. And, of course, I'm going to talk crazy and tell you, no, Messiah not going here. If you feel like I was being arrogant, that's my business. I could be arrogant. And trust me, as you grow up as a mom, as Amanda grow up as a mom, she going to realize who not to let her kid around. I feel like because they don't have kids, they act the way they act. If they had a kid...
Okay, I don't know what's going on. Not going to get into it.
Going to somebody else's house and making somebody else money.
I'm not
going
to get into that. But anyway, you guys, I'm about to get out of here and just sit here and put some socks on because I stuck my feet in the pool and we'll get more videos until my husband get up. He's supposed to be making us a BLT, but he's still sleeping. It's 12 o'clock, so he'll get up about 1 or 2 o'clock. And if he make a BLT, oh, hell yeah, I'm going to still eat. I'm not turning down even. I had some grits. But anyway, I'm about to get out of here. Peace.